Hello everybody, welcome to iExamBee's Legal Bee. This is Amrita, your law faculty here at iExamBee. In this video today, we are going to continue with the series that I have started for most important questions for SEBI Grade A Legal Officer examination. If you have not yet subscribed to Legal Bee, do subscribe it and stay tuned for all these kind of beneficial videos which are helpful in your exam preparation. Content as well as strategic preparation videos are available on Legal Bee. You can also check out the online courses that are available at iExamBee's website for the preparation of all the examinations like SEBI, RBI, IBPS, SO, IBPS, RRB Law Officer, etc. In case of any queries, reach out to us by writing us an email on hello@iExamBee.com. Call us on the number 920-552-4028. Write to us in the comment section of this video. Download our app for 50% faster job preparation. 300 most important MCQ series I have started for the preparation of SEBI Grade A Legal Officer exam. This is the ninth part of our video series in which we will be covering questions from Partnership Act. Which of the following is not a valid partnership? Partnership arising out of contract, partnership for a particular adventure, partnership arising out of status, none of the above, all of the above. Now what they have asked you, be careful that the word not has been used over here. They are asking you that which is not a valid partnership. So this is how we have to be very careful with the words, or else the answer completely reverses or completely changes. Partnership arising out of contract, partnership for particular adventure, partnership arising out of status, none of the above, all of the above. Correct answer is C, partnership arising out of status. Partnership not created by status. This is very clear to us in all the sections for Partnership Act, section 5, if you can refer. So partnership arising out of status is not true about partnership. Where no provision is made by contract between the partners for determination of their partnership. That kind of a partnership is partnership at will, general partnership, special partnership by status, particular partnership. Kaun se type ki partnership hai jisme determination of partnership nahi diya hua tha. The correct answer is partnership at will. As per section 7 of Indian Partnership Act, it is covered in this that partnership at will is not having any predetermined period of the partnership. Whenever they want to dissolve the partnership, the partners give a notice and they dissolve it at that time, at their will. Which of the following statement is true? Partners entitled to receive remuneration for taking part in the conduct of business. Partners are not required to share equally in the profits earned. Where a partner is entitled to interest on the capital subscribed by him, such interest shall be payable only out of losses. B and C are correct. None of the above is correct. When we talk about the true statements, which of the following are the true statements? Here, none of the above is true. All these statements are false. Partners are not getting any remuneration. They are not doing a job in conducting the business. They are doing the business. They share equal liability in the profits earned. Liability also, and they get the equal share also in the profits earned. So all of these statements are false, correct? And these are understood by us in mutual rights and liabilities under section 13, subjected to contract between the partners. All these things have been covered. Property of a partnership firm can be used exclusively for business of the firm, can be used to meet personal losses of partners, can be used for business of firm, any of B and C, none of the above. So when we talk about property of a partnership firm, property of the partnership firm can be used exclusively for the business of the firm. This is very clear to us. Section 15 deals with application of property of the firm. Anyone who knowingly permits himself to be represented to be a partner in a firm is liable as a partner to anyone who has the faith, who has on faith of any such representation given credit to the firm. Who is liable only if he is aware that such representation has reached the person so giving credit. Shall be liable if the person so representing himself knows or does not know that the representation has reached the person so giving credit. A and C are correct. A and B are correct. So anyone who knowingly permits himself to be represented to be a partner in a firm is liable. D, answer D, that is A as well as C. He's liable if someone has given credit on the faith that he is representing himself to be a partner. And even if he does not know that the representation has reached the person, then also he is liable. Both the conditions he is going to be liable, covered under section 28, holding out. A retiring partner shall be liable until public notice of retirement is given, Be discharged from his liabilities for acts of the firm carried out after his date of retirement. Be discharged for any liability to third party for acts of firm before retirement also by an agreement made by him with such third party and reconstituted firm. A and B are correct. A, B and C, all of these are correct. So a retiring partner shall, all of these are correct, be liable until the public notice of retirement is given, discharged from the liabilities for the firm, which are after his date of retirement, and he is liable to third party. He will be discharged from his liability to third party after he has dissolved himself and the firm is reconstituted. Section 32 makes it clear. Clause 2 and Clause 3 specifically cover these points. So all of these are correct. Every partner of a firm is liable - for all acts of the firm. So the partner's liability is of what kind? Joint, several, both A and B, either A or B, coextensively to his share. Coextensive hoti to ye to limited liability partnership ban jata. So the correct answer over here is both A and B, joint as well as several liability exists for the partners. Section 25, liability of a partner for the acts of the firm. Every partner is liable jointly with all the other partners and also severally for all acts of the firm done while he is a partner. Which of the following is the appropriate definition of partnership? Relation between partners, persons who have agreed to share the profits of a business, persons acting jointly to carry out a trade or an occupation, all carrying out business or any of them acting for all. A and C are correct, B and C are correct. So which of the following is the appropriate definition of partnership has been asked over here? Correct answer is D. A as well as C. Relation between persons who have agreed to share profits of a business. And along with that C, persons all act carrying out business in any of them acting for all. Indian Partnership Act Section 4 defines the partnership. Out of that you can make out what are the necessary ingredients of partnership and what is the appropriate definition. Which of the following is not true about partnership? Defined under Section 4, created by contract, not created by status, HUF carrying out business in a partnership firm, none of the above. Now what they have asked you over here, that which of the following is not true about partnership. So what is not true means what is false. Now it is defined under Section 4, ye to abhi humne pichle question mein dekh liya. Created by contract, ye bhi correct statement hai. Not created by status bhi correct statement hai. Because wahan pe kya diya hai? Not created. We know that it is not created by status as per Section 5. So, HUF carrying out business in a partnership firm is not a partnership firm. This is made to us very clear under Section 5 itself that an HUF carrying on a family business is not a partnership. So the false statement or a statement which is not true is option D. When a partner exercises authority in an emergency and protects the firm from loss, then such act shall bind the firm. Shall not bind the firm, shall bind only the partner exercising authority, shall bind the designated partners, shall bind only the active partners and not the sleeping partners. So when a partner exercises authority in an emergency, protects the firm from loss, then that act shall bind the firm. Section 21 deals with partner's authority in an emergency. Only thing is that he should act with ordinary prudence and he should act reasonably. Partnership is created by a contract, implied consent, agreement only, conduct of parties, status of the business. How is a partnership created? Now these are very basic questions. But the way they are asked and the way options are there, we get confused for a second. That should not happen. Be prepared with your concepts thoroughly and the questions. Correct answer is A contract. Section 4 and 5 of the Partnership Act covers this area. It is created by a contract, that is your partnership deed. Which of the following is a valid mode of dissolution of a partnership? Notice, expiry of fixed term, death of partner, any partner, A and B, A, B and C. Which of the following can be a valid mode of dissolution of a partnership? Correct answer is E. All of these are the valid modes covered under Section 40 to 44 of the Partnership Act. All the modes of dissolution you should know. Partners have the duty to indemnify the loss caused to the firm if firm dissolves, losses caused by fraud of the creditors, losses caused by fraud of the partners, loss caused by anybody, any of the above. So partners are having the duty to indemnify the loss caused to the firm if, correct answer is C, losses caused by fraud of the partners. At that time they are having the duty to indemnify. It is their duty. Section 10 covers this. In partnership, partners' liabilities are unlimited, limited to the capital of business, limited, both A and C are correct. A unlimited as well as limited. Both A and B are correct. It is unlimited but limited to the capital of the business. Again, the options are making it confusing, isn't it? Correct answer is A, unlimited. Don't get confused. Just the most appropriate answer as it is provided to us, it is unlimited, so it is unlimited. Partners have an unlimited personal liability towards their firm. Which of the following is not a right of a partner? Inspection of books, repayment of loans, payment of interests, share of profits, accounting. यहाँ पे ऐसी कौन सी चीज है जो राइट नहीं है, विच इज नॉट अ राइट ऑफ अ पार्टनर. करेक्ट आंसर इज ई, अकाउंटिंग, बिकॉज अकाउंटिंग इज अ ड्यूटी ऑफ अ पार्टनर. ही हैज टू डू इट, ही हैज टू मेंटेन द अकाउंट्स. ही इज नॉट हैविंग अ राइट. नाउ हियर यू कैन सी हाउ इट हैज बीन ट्विस्टेड. वी मे फील दैट दिस इज नॉट अ राइट एट ऑल, बट देन वी सी दैट ऑल द ऑप्शंस आर रिलेटेड, ऑल द थिंग्स द पार्टनर कैन डू, बट व्हाट ही कैन डू एज अ मैटर ऑफ राइट एंड व्हाट ही कैन डू एज अ मैटर ऑफ ड्यूटी इज डिफरेंट थिंग. Which of the following is not a feature of partnership business? Two or more persons, agreement, mutual agency, sharing of profits, separate legal identity. They are asking you which of the following is not a feature. Be careful of that. Not a feature, correct answer is E. Separate legal entity is not there. It is a distinct feature of a company. It is not there in a partnership. Yes, it exists in a limited liability partnership, but not in a partnership. Which section defines rights of an outgoing partner? Section 36, 40, 33, 32, 35. Now, I think two or three sections are already clear to you. 32 retiring partner hai, abhi humne dekha. 40 modes of dissolution ki baat karta hai. Toh correct answer yahan pe kya hai? The section that defines rights of an outgoing partner is section 36 of the Indian Partnership Act. Rights of outgoing partners, rights of incoming partners, all of these should be clear to you. Can minors be admitted to the benefits of partnership? No, yes, sometimes depending on consent of the guardian also, if the court orders with an undertaking up till the age of majority. So when we talk about the admission of minors to the benefits of partnership, yes, minors can be admitted to the benefits of partnership. Section 30 covers minors admitted to the benefits of partnership. It is obviously subjected to the consent of all the partners. When partnership firm can be dissolved by an agreement, by court, when some dispute arises, death of the partners, with consent of all the partners, none of these. So when partnership firm can be dissolved by an agreement, correct answer is D, with consent of all the partners, section 40, dissolution by agreement. After dissolution of firm, its goodwill can be sold, will remain as it is, will dissolve, cannot be sold, no action even if it is destroyed. So after a dissolution of firm, its goodwill can be sold. Option A is correct. It can be sold and this is covered under partnership property. Section 14 discusses this, partnership property. And in that, you will understand that goodwill is also a partnership property, so it can be solved. I hope all of these questions are helping you all. You can download these PPTs also, keep it with you and practice. Whenever you require any suggestions or you have any doubts relating to the questions or the topics, you can reach out to us in the comment section of the video as well. We are there to help you out, or write us an email, call us on this number. Check out the demos of our courses on www.iexamby.com. Prepare 50% faster with us. Download our app from the Google's Play Store. Hamare app par full course access available. Even online, offline course access also you can get on iExamby's app. Thank you everybody. Have a good day.